This river carries all the goods of Africa up toward the Suez Canal.
Now, all of a sudden, no boats here. What could have scared them away?
That's what we're here to find out.
Do you believe the wild stories of the monster Sphinx?
Anything is possible.
See anything, Dad?
Yes. There are a band of nomads. Nobody knows the desert like they do.
Then they'd be the ones to ask about the disturbances.
Good suggestion.
Hey, boss, I don't like it here.
Who asked you to like it? It is time to send my pet kitten out for another little stroll.
He's all set.
His electric brain is programmed for 3 full days of destruction, including all the appropriate countermeasures to whatever futile attempts the authorities may make to stop him. Come to life, my beauty. Let your eyes destroy all they survey. Now, rise, my pet. Rise and walk. Go as far as Suez and destroy the Great Canal.
The Suez Canal.
Now the world shall know the wrath of Doctor Who. Now they will pay the price. I shall remove their marvels one by one till there are no wonders left but my own.
We'd better leave Kong here, Bobby. No sense scaring off the natives needlessly.
Wait here, buddy. I'll call you if I need you. Gee, this is exciting. It's too bad Susan and Captain Engelhorn stayed behind today. Look what they missed.
I'm sure Susan is enjoying the tour.
Yeah, but what excitement can she find like this on the Suez Canal?
This is the Suez, gateway to Eastern Africa, the Indies, and all of Asia.
Ah, that's the truth. Without the sea, world trade would evaporate.
No! It can't be!
Help! Help! Look!
Make for shore!
A giant sphinx!
He's heading right for us! Doctor Who?
So you're the root of the mystery. I should have guessed.
I feel flattered, Professor Bond.
You can't lick the whole world, Doctor Who.
No, my little friend. Even now, the Suez Canal is being destroyed. That will do for a start.
Sue and Captain Engelhorn.
Kong.
Yes, where is your gorilla?
Kong!
Let your ape do what he will. The canal is doomed!
Kong can catch him, Dad.
No time for that, Bobby. Kong's the only chance we have of saving your sister and the Suez Canal.
Swim for shore! The crew has jumped the ship!
Well, I've never left the ship. Take me to your wheelhouse.
Hurry, Captain. Get him, Kong!
He needs time to regenerate his eye guns.
He's short-circuiting, blowing his fuses.
Glad you and Kong got here when you did.
I'm glad it's over.
So that's the end of Doctor Who's Sphinx.
But it's not the end of Doctor Who.
What on earth is Kong doing?
He's pretending he's watching his favorite movie.
Oh, that's the silliest thing I ever heard of.
It's not so silly. He's got a pretty powerful imagination. See for yourself.
Easy, Bobby. Easy. You're giving the wheel too much play. Just try to hold her steady.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Good boy. Well, I think that's enough for your first lesson.
Gee, that was great. Thanks for letting me hold the wheel, Captain Engelhorn.
The wheel, Bobby. Grab the wheel. Phew, that was a close one.
Holly! Holly! Gee, if anything happens to your mascot, I'll never forgive myself. There he is! I'll save him, Captain.
Bobby! Bobby, wait! Oh, I better get you back to your father while you're still in one piece.
It was my fault that Holly fell overboard, Dad.
Well, no harm done. You've got a brave boy there. Come on, Holly. We've got to get back to the ship. Well, looks like you made a friend, Bobby. Well, I don't suppose a day's shore leave would do him any harm. If it's all right with your father, that is.
Is it okay, Dad?
Well, now, he looks like he might have a pretty big appetite.
Oh, boy, that's great. Come on, Holly. Come on, boy. Go away, Kong. Go away. You're frightening him. Go away. That's all right, fella. Kong won't hurt you. Okay, Holly. Kong, go away!
Thank you.
could he have gone? Holy! I hear him now. Look, he's with Kong. Kong, I thought I told you to leave Holly alone. Well, what's the matter with him?
Honestly, boys are so dumb sometimes. Can't you see? Kong thinks you don't want him anymore, now that you've got Holly.
Whatever gave him an idea like that?
Honestly, boys.
Well, fella, did you enjoy your leave? Well, it looks as though someone else is coming to see Holly off. Well, well, a going away present, too. Say, that's a strange looking bone. Don't think I ever saw one like that before. What kind is it?
Looks like the neck bone of some prehistoric bird. Dodo, I think.
Well, Bobby, perhaps Holly can come back for a visit again sometime.
If it's all the same to you, Captain, I'm not sure that's such a good idea. I already got the best pet in the whole world. And besides, he's a little, J-E-A-L-O-U-S.
Oh, I think I know what you mean, Bobby.
Come on, Kong.
King Kong, you know the name of King Kong. You know the fame of King Kong. 10 times as big as a man.
Tigers? Near the North Pole?
Dad had a report of 2 saber-toothed tigers frozen in the ice near here. Perfectly preserved.
This is Charles Sanderson Macluck, government geologist.
Did you find out where the tigers are?
Quite a distance from here.
Wouldn't it be funny if the tigers aren't really frozen dead?
Historical.
Here we are.
I've been expecting you 3 days running. Come on in. Soup's on. Don't know where I'm going to put the big one. Don't get guests that large these days.
He won't be any trouble, Mr. Packer.
Mr. Macluck says you're the man that saw the tiger.
You're sure it was a saber-toothed tiger?
Well, it was nigh on 20 feet tall at the shoulders, all striped, tusks onto it, stuck in an ice wall it was, clear as glass. There was 2 of them. Make mighty nice bookends.
We're going to dig them out, aren't we, Dad?
Melt them out is more like it, Bobby. I want to try to keep them as well-preserved as I can. The cold ought to be a help.
It ought to make history, Professor. 2 saber-tooths.
Want to get the equipment, Macluck?
I've never seen him like this before.
There's nothing to be afraid of. They can't hurt us, Kong.
How's it going?
We're getting there. It won't be long now.
Mind if I stick around and watch the fun? You people are tired watching. I'll keep an eye on things. Yeah, you go get some rest. I'll call if anything happens.
We'd appreciate that.
Just leave it to me. Never thawed out tigers before, but I reckon I can figure out how it goes. Get a good night's rest.
They couldn't.
They did. I must have fallen asleep, and I thought I was having a nightmare.
It's against all scientific fact, Professor.
Can you lend me a rifle?
Back at the post. I got enough stuff to start a war.
I'm afraid that's what we're going to have. Look, it's my fault. I'm the one who has to get them before they tear up every village in the area.
At least take someone along who knows the North.
He's right. This is no place to get lost in, because you'd never be found.
I'll go along, Professor.
Take him, Dad.
And take Kong.
I'll take Makluk, but Kong stays here. If I'm going to track those tigers, I want to be inconspicuous. I think you better warn every village and trading post. Tell them what's happened.
Check.
Come on, Makluk.
Good hunting, Dad.
I hope so, son. I hope so.
Should have taken Kong.
Yeah, there's already reports about a village being destroyed. I hope your father finds those too.
I sort of hope he doesn't. He's out there, Kong. And if he finds them, he's gonna have trouble. Well, are you coming with me or not?
I'm going in after him. I'll try to get them out. I'll take one from the cave. You take the other when it comes through here.
All right, but maybe I ought to go. I'm familiar with ice and snow.
It's my fault all this happened. This is my job, Makluk.
Where's my father? Come on, Kong.
Stay away from that cave, Bobby.
Kong can handle those tigers.
Something's happened in there. Don't make it worse. Wait until we know what it is.
Dad.
Bobby, can you hear me?
Yes, Dad. Are you all right?
Listen to me carefully. Don't come into the cave. Don't make any loud noises. The roof in here is about to go. Any vibration is going to set it off.
Can you get out?
Bobby, there's one thing I can do. I'm going to fire at one of those tigers.
The cave will fall in on you.
That's the way it's got to be. That's the only way to keep these beasts from causing more harm. Stand back from the cave, Bobby.
Move back, Kong. Back! I hope the tigers come out first, but be careful. It might be my dad.
Preparing the warrior's feast, very rare these days. It's for someone who's done something very brave.
Come on, Kong. Oh, he's feeling shy. Come on, Kong.
I have now seen everything.
Hey, Kong, I just read this book on mind reading. Concentrate on something real hard, and I'll tell you what you're thinking about. Oh, that's an easy one.
What is it, Kong? What do you want? Bobby, can you figure out what this animal wants?
That's easy, Sue. He wants what everyone else wants. This. Won't take long. We'll visit that children's home and then we can take our vacation.
Sorry, Kong. That's the price of fame. I'd better call Engelhorn.
I don't see any kids.
Probably all inside waiting for their guest.
Funny looking place for children. No playground or slides.
Bobby, you and Kong wait by the truck. We don't want to take them by surprise.
Welcome, Professor Bond. Welcome. I am delighted to have you as house guests. I regret it will not be for long, unless you do as I request.
What do you want, Doctor Who?
Kong.
Kong will never follow you, and you know it.
Exactly. But he will do as your son tells him to, won't he?
You will please follow the hallway in front of you, Professor Bond.
What about my son?
He is safe, Professor. Safer than you.
He's got Kong with him, Dad.
Suddenly, I miss that monkey.
A magnificent job of construction.
It will do the job.
It had better. Master Bond.
Doctor Who?
We needn't mince words. I need Kong, that you know. He will not obey me, but he will obey you.
If you do not do as I say, you will never see your family or Captain Engelhorn again.
You don't give me much choice.
You will tell Kong that he must do everything I ask of him.
I didn't think it was that big.
Where's my father? If you've done anything to him, I'll tell Kong to tear this place apart.
There. You see them?
Dad?
Soundproof. The least you might expect from Doctor Who.
Kong!
I suggest you call off your beast. Watch. The room in there was designed especially for this meeting. It is controlled by my voice, and my voice alone. I have only to say the right words now. The first demonstration. Cold.
Look, frost.
The refrigerating coils can bring the temperature in the room down to 75 degrees below zero.
Of course, we have the other extreme. Heat.
That's better. It's getting warmer.
Too warm.
The heating coils can bring the temperature up to 250 degrees above zero.
Kong, you'll have to do what Doctor Who says. You hear? Satisfied?
You will, of course, permit me one test before I buy.
Kong, go to the gatehouse and destroy it.
Get moving, kid.
You! I had to do it.
I know. Don't worry about it, son.
We have much to do.
Kong!
He can't hear you.
Show him, Bobby. Show him how to break the window.
He thinks it's a game. How wonderful, Shreklick.
A little risky, though, Doctor.
Nonsense. The big ape is amused. Ah, now the final phase. And we come to the end of Bond and his family. A long time to wait, but worth it.
I can't get him to understand. This room is getting smaller.
I think we are finished, Professor. Bobby, if you could only make your monkey disobey once in a while.
But I can. Then do it fast. Captain Engelhorn, hit me.
Me? Oh, that big monkey would kill me if I touched you.
Hurry!
I won't hurt you, Bobby. You tell Kong.
Hurry up!
Kong, you will do as I say. Immediately, Kong. Stop him!
Do something!
Heat!
Thank you.
Kong, put him down! Friend, Kong! Friend! Kong, come on, put him on the ground. He's a nice man.
Very nice, Kong. I'm very nice.
Sure he is, Kong. He's going to buy us that airplane model I liked. And bananas for you.
Yes, yes. Ooh, blackmail.
Well, maybe I'll chip in too, Captain.
We're bored.
Well, you won't be for long.
We won't?
Nope. Just 1 week from today, you'll have all the action you want. Watch.
No need to worry. We'll just dig our way out.
Well, let's get started.
It's a catastrophe, Professor Bond. Disastrous. Anchorage is sinking. The sea around us is rising at the rate of 5 feet a day. Soon we'll be completely underwater. But here, take a better look.
There isn't much left.
Yes, unless the cause of this flood is discovered and stopped, the city is doomed.
You've been very helpful, Mr. Mayor.
Can you help us?
I have a theory, Mr. Mayor, only a hunch.
Well, we must put all our faith in it, whatever it is.
We'll do our best.
He does the work of 100. Handy fellow to have around.
Are we far from the North Pole, Commander Kraft?
About 65 miles. We were lucky to get this far. Not much ice here for so close to the pole. Strange.
May be right about the cause of the floods.
Oh?
He thinks a giant meteor may have fallen on the polar cap. Its radioactive heat could melt enough ice to flood the northern hemisphere. Look, here they come. Hiya, Kong!
Well, Commander, is everything ready for our trip to the pole?
Your equipment is aboard the sled, sir.
We'll leave Kong here for the time being, Bobby. There's a possibility of radioactivity ahead.
You wait here, buddy. I'll be back for you.
How far have we come?
Almost there.
I'm getting some radioactivity. Look!
goodness, but it's warm. Are you sure we're at the North Pole?
By my calculations, we're standing on it right now.
Not quite, Commander, but you're getting warm.
Who said that?
Professor Bond. Fancy meeting you here.
It's Doctor Who.
It is ironic, Professor Bond, that we should meet again so soon.
I should have known that you were behind this.
You do me much honor, Professor. But grant me a simple request, and I will spare the world its present misfortunes.
You're suggesting blackmail, of course.
Of course. My ingenious meltifier you see before you will drown the entire Western Hemisphere in a rising flood of melting ice at my whim.
I have no authority to negotiate with you.
You underestimate your professional reputation, Professor. I'm sure a carefully worded report from you would convince the authorities of the Western world of the hopelessness of their position.
You'll get no cooperation from me.
But you forget. You and your family are my prisoners.
Not for long.
You are referring to your big friend, Kong. But he doesn't seem to be here. Surely, if he were, I might have noticed him. This is the heart of my meltifier, an atomic reactor. Through my genius, it superheats the ice below, which causes the length of the entire polar cap, melting more and more ice to water. For the last time, Professor Bond, will you yield to me?
Never.
Bring the boy to me. Well, my curious little friend, would you like an inside look at a real atomic reactor?
You don't scare me!
You miserable brat! I'll do this myself!
The end of a mad ambition.
It's getting cold.
Yes, things are back to normal again.
Thanks to Kong.
Yes, thanks to Kong.
What is it, Kong? What's the matter? Oh, no wonder he's excited. Take a look at this. Now pay attention, Kong. Dad says the world you've been living in is millions of years old, so it's time you were brought up to date. Now here is the first thing you have to know.
Come on, Fish. You expect me to sit here all day. That's more like it. No, Kong. I want to do it myself.
Thank you.
here's a picture that looks like the fish I caught. Okay, okay, we caught. See, the name is right there. Ixilok. I'll show it to Dad. It must be very important if it's in this book. Dad? Dad? Susan, have you seen Dad? Oh, no!
What's the matter?
You're cleaning it!
Well,
that fish is Ixilok, a very important scientific discovery of mine. Ours.
Well, how was I supposed to know? Bobby, there's something inside him. Look, it's a statue. I think it's gold.
Solid gold, Bobby. It's a statue of the ancient Etruscan goddess Uni.
Uni?
Over 2,000 years ago, her temple was swallowed up by the sea. The legendary temple of Uni. Ancient stories say it was made of gold, too. Bobby, could you show me where you caught that fish?
Right about here, Dad.
It's just a long shot, but the temple of Uni might not be far from here.
Dad's in trouble.
The Temple of Uni. I was this close to it. But it's right in the center of an underwater whirlpool.
Couldn't you tie a cable to it, maybe, and pull it up?
The suction of that whirlpool makes it impossible for anyone to go near it without being hopelessly trapped. Where there's a will, there's a way, they say, but I'm afraid all we have is the will. Good it does me, that temple might just as well be on the moon as a half mile offshore.
Better than that, Dad. It's on the beach.
What? What do you mean?
Look! On the beach! Kong must have figured out a way to bring it up.
Then Kong can take his place with the greatest engineers of all time.
Are you letting Kong keep that crown?
You want to try to take it away from him?
king. Come, you know the name of king. Come, you know the fame of king. Come, 10 times as big as a man. One day a boy, too young to know the danger, made a friend of this giant fearsome stranger. And the life they led on their island home became a legend, the legend of King Kong. You know the name of King Kong, you know the fame of King Kong, 10 times as big as a man.
On schedule. Take a look, Professor Lubov.
Good. This island is the key to our new master strategy. With a ground station at exactly this spot, we can keep a fleet of nuclear missiles constantly threatening our enemies.
Uh-oh. Trouble.
Let's go, Kong. We don't want to fool around with a killer triceratops, Bobby. That's the most vicious animal in the world. He doesn't kill for food. He kills for pleasure.
He sure looks the part.
We should be ready to begin operations very soon. That is good.
I have sent word to Professor Bond as you requested, inviting him to tea.
Very good. His knowledge of the island will be useful. When he has told us all he knows, we can dispense with his services.
Here he comes.
Ah, Professor Bond, my greetings to a fellow scientist.
It's a privilege to share an island with Dr. Lubov.
Thank you.
But I would have come without the guard.
Purely for your protection, of course. We have heard so many stories of great beasts on this island. Are they true?
Well, I have survived.
There, you see. Professor Bond will be so helpful on our mission. Come inside, out of the sun.
Just what is your mission here, Dr. Lubov?
The same as yours, Professor. To investigate and learn.
You're intrigued by the unique vegetation on the island?
Exactly.
But your government is not in the habit of sending their top nuclear scientist and a ballistic general out to the South Seas to pick daisies. What are you really here for?
I am not at liberty to say, except to say you already know too much. You are in the way. Like every other obstacle on this island, you must be eliminated.
I wouldn't do that.
Ouch! My arm! Be careful, you fools!
The general!
Get on about your work.
There will be no work for us here unless we liquidate that big gorilla.
That will be difficult. Bullets don't stop him. We must trap him.
General, we have the prisoner.
Excellent.
Ah, the gorilla's little friend.
You bet I am. And when Kong finds out I'm missing, he'll be back and wreck the whole place.
And when he returns to rescue you, we shall be prepared. Take him away.
General, the brute is coming.
Good. We are ready for him. Boy, You see, we have planned a warm welcome for your gorilla friend.
How do you say? A hot reception.
You see this ring of stakes around you? Each one will shortly come alive with a nuclear voltage of electricity. The opposite charges of their voltage will jump to anything that comes between the posts. King Kong will be cooked to hamburger when he enters our electrical fence. Shocking, isn't it?
Kong won't come. I won't let him.
But surely he will give his life to rescue you, little boy.
The brute is coming.
Clear the area.
Turn on the generator.
No, Kong, don't! It's a trap, Dad. Don't let him touch it. It's charged with electricity. Don't come any closer.
Kong! Keep calm, Bobby. We'll get you out of there.
It's not working.
Wait. He comes again.
The current. Get Bobby now, Kong.
Everybody to the boats.
Pull faster. Pull.
Look.
Damn, it's a long row back to the homeland.
You sure took care of them, Kong.
That's not all he did, son.
What do you mean, Dad?
Kong is the first one in history to get a killer triceratops to do a good deed.
For those of you who don't understand my friend too well, this is what he just said. And they all lived happily ever after. Did you like that story, Kong? Well, if you think that was exciting, wait till you hear this.
Dr. Nordman has invited us to pay him a visit. He wants me to see his latest invention.
What about Kong?
Kong can come, too. Nordman lives on a remote mountain near San Francisco, Bobby. We'll sail on the professor's yacht, and Kong can swim along with us. When do we leave, Captain?
As soon as you're ready, sir.
Dr. Nordman.
Good to see you, Dr. Bond. You did bring the big ape, didn't you?
Of course we did. Bobby, call Kong.
Good. Bond, I must show you something on the top of the mountain at once. I think it would be better if the boy and his companion waited here.
Oh, gee.
I'm sorry, Bobby, but I have a special reason.
Very impressive.
I'll show it to you.
What is it, Dad?
A solar mirror. A giant reflector of the sun's rays.
Exactly, Dr. Bond. Nordman built it for peaceful purposes, but I persuaded him to change his mind.
Dad, it's Doctor Who.
Nordman, what's going on here?
I had to do it, Bond. He's keeping my family as hostages.
What do you want with me this time, Who?
I'm using you as bait, Dr. Bond. I'm going to make sure that a certain big ape doesn't interfere with my plans again. Look out there. San Francisco, target number one.
You mean you're going to...
Use the mirror to destroy the city. Then I'll move from city to city by night until the entire West Coast is at my mercy. Then I'll deal with the government in Washington.
He can do it, Bond. That mirror will focus the rays of the sun into a deadly heat ray, effective for 50 miles.
Let's give him a demonstration, Professor.
First, Dr. Nordman invites us to come all the way here, and then he won't let us see his invention. Mm-hmm. Come on, Kong. Let's at least get a little closer.
Mm-hmm. That's 4-inch steel, Dr. Bond. Imagine what it will do to buildings, to people. Speak.
The boy and Kong are climbing the mountain.
Excellent. We'll be ready for them. I knew I could count on that boy's curiosity.
Just a little higher, Kong.
This is what I've been waiting for. Soon my worst enemy will go up in smoke.
Dad, he's going to turn that thing on Kong.
Here he comes. Get him, Nordman. Get him.
I've got to refocus the mirror.
Bobby, tell Kong to stay away.
Dad, Sue.
Go back. Go back, Kong.
You come any closer, and I'll shoot them both.
It's Dr. Who, Kong. He's got Dad and Susan.
Hurry, you clumsy fool. Hurry.
I can't do it.
Get out of the way.
Kong, keep away. Bobby, don't let him.
We've got to do something, Kong. We've got to.
He's fascinated with his own reflection. Keep away, Kong!
About your mirror, Professor Nordman.
Don't feel sorry, Bobby. I'll build another. Besides, it was the only way to stop Doctor Who.
Kong really threw a monkey wrench into his plans, didn't you, Kong?
A great big monkey wrench, Bobby.
What are you two doing?
We're going away on a trip in search of adventure.
How long will you be gone?
Exactly 1 week.
And just what kind of adventure do you expect to find?
Oh, I don't know. Probably something like this.